Members, we formed a quorum and it's also the appointed time. May I call the meeting to order? Welcome to the special meeting of the PWSC. We have only one item for one paper for our discussion, and that is the forecast of submissions for the 2017-18 Legislative Council session. PWSCI for information, 2017-18-5. The administration submitted an information paper to the PWSC setting out the 92 submissions to the PWSC within the 2017-18 session to facilitate members' understanding of these items earlier. So the administration expects that about 92 submissions will be made to the PWSC within this session. We have members from the administration present to answer members' questions. If you have any queries in relation to any of the items, feel free to put questions to the administration. Because this is just an information paper and no funding request is involved, we do not have any item or motion for voting. And as I said, the motions under paragraph 32A of the Public Works Subcommittee procedure will not apply to this item. If members have further views on any of the items, you are also welcome to write to the relevant policy bureau or member or the relevant panel for further discussion. The Secretariat of the PWSC will invite members to confirm items that should be discussed at the relevant panel in the first place, and the Secretariat will convey the message to the policy bureaus for appropriate consultation arrangements. For this item, we have the following members present: Mr. Yam, the Commissioner for Heritage and Culture, and Mrs. Lam Yukawai, Director of Architectural Services; Mr. Yip Shing Tak, Technical Consultant from ASD; Mr. Lam Shai Hong, Director of Civil Engineering, CNED; Mr. Tong Ka Hong, Director of Drainage Services; Mr. Zhong Kam Hua, Director of Highways; and Mr. Wong Chung Leung, Director of Water Supplies; and Mr. Lai Chung Hong, the Deputy Director from EMSD. Thank you. I'll give the floor to the administration for a briefing first. Thank you. The purpose of the paper is to set out a work plan to members for this year, to give an overview of the possible capital works items to our members, to facilitate members' understanding. As set out in the paper, we expect to submit 92 projects covering 10 projects that were not endorsed or examined in the last session, and one for overall submission, and one to increase the approved estimates of works, and also the remaining are new works projects. As at the 29th of November 2017, we have approved 7 projects not approved in the last session, costing $7.7 billion. As regards the 80-odd submissions to be submitted, they will cost over $130 billion. Members will understand that these are the best estimate we can make at this moment. As regards the actual time frame for submission, it depends on the state of preparation and also the outcome of consultation with relevant panels, and will also be subject to the progress of the PWSC. We have representatives from various works departments and bureaus to answer members' questions. But this is just a beginning. If after the meeting members have further inquiries on any of the items here, feel free to approach these departments directly. I'm sure they will be more than happy to answer members' queries. I hope this will help to shorten the time for examination of these projects by PWSC in the future. Thank you. When members would like to speak, press the request to speak button, please. Ms. Tanya Chen, 4 minutes. Thank you, Chairman. I'd like to know whether we have had similar meetings in the past, because my impression, my memory is a bit blurred. And then, for the last item, is the Hong Kong China Macau Bridge. 8003QR. So already widely reported in the media, the increased in APE, but you haven't got any target date for submission. I'd like to know how come you can stall for so long. Ms. Tanya Chen asked a question about arrangement. Starting from 2002, at the start of each legislative session, the administration would provide a list of submissions to be made in the in that session to let members of PWSC have a better idea of our work plan for this year. There were special meetings held to discuss such items. Of course, special meetings are sometimes held to discuss these meetings, and I think it's better that we convene a special meeting to discuss the list of submissions here. Mr. Chong Kam-wa, thank you. Ms. Tanya Chen. This item is about the main bridge of the mainland that is cost overrun, and we are going to apply for additional funding. It's been reported in many newspapers already. The THB has issued statements for the media. In fact, it's a press release to the media about the main bridge. The cost overrun is about 1,000 billion renminbi, 10 billion renminbi. We have to bear about 2 billion renminbi of the cost overrun. However, we cannot just come to LegCo for this additional funding because we have not yet exhausted the regional approved budget. We will have to see what is the balance left, and then we'll also have to discuss the bridge administration of the mainland and relevant departments. We have to ask them for information to verify the relevant figures. When the information is properly compiled, then we will come to LegCo and ask for extra funding. I believe members would like to have a full, a clear account of the figures, so it takes a bit of time for us to put things together. Any follow-up? Nothing from me. Thank you. Mr. Roy Kwong, first time, 4 minutes. Thank you, Chairman. I've got two questions. The Development Bureau has got an item, item 2, 30, 3794CL, the demolition of existing superstructures at Caroline Hill Road site, Causeway Bay. Two policy addresses are involved, one by part by Siwan Leung and the other by Carrie Lam. Now, this current status is Town Board has approved its new use, and its current zoning is GIC, and the relevant district council has yet to discuss this as well. But all of a sudden, it is now number two on the list, and I'd like to know the reasons for that. And can someone from the administration enlighten me on the following? So the Hong Kong Chai Macau Bridge is an item involving cost overrun. How many other items will have a cost overrun? I know this is not the PWC, but I would like to have some hints as to the number of cost overrun projects involved. Mr. Lau, thank you. In my opening remarks, I said that we have got four items to increase the approved estimate. So there are four. How much is involved? We're still confirming, verifying the actual amount, and we cannot give an exact figure now. Well, even though it's just a very rough, please give us a rough idea so we will not be shocked if it is another cost overrun of over $10 billion, we'll be worried. So for the remaining three items, what are they, and do you have any rough idea as to the amount involved? As Mr. Lau said, they're still verifying the figures, so they cannot give you anything exact, but then can the Deputy Secretary tell us what are those items?
One of the projects is the Hong Kong Macau Zhuhai Bridge, and the estimate for the main deck of the bridge. We also have the Sha Tin Central Link project and the cost overrun for that project. There is also the Sha Tin Central Link, Sha Tin Central Link remaining works. There is also an increase in the project estimate. There is one more item. Yes, Mr. Lau? It's item 21, the Kai Tak Development Project, the district chilling system. That's the... So regarding the demolition of the Caroline Hill site, who would like to answer that question? Director of Architectural Services, Ms. Lam. Thank you. Regarding the demolition of the Caroline Hill Road site, this is only the demolition of the existing superstructures occupied by the CAS. I know the background. We already had a discussion earlier. We understand that there is objection from the residents in the area. They're not objecting to the demolition. The objection is that they don't know what will be the future development for the site. Have you expedited this project? And that's why it's now, you know, at the top of the list. Mr. Lau, Undersecretary. If I may explain to Mr. Kwong that at the last legislative session, in the final PWSC meeting, there was already an extensive discussion, but we're not able to complete the scrutiny of this item. So this is actually an item carried forward from the last legislative session. As I said, the items carried over from the last session, seven of them have already been dealt with earlier. There are three outstanding items, including this one, which is the demolition of the existing superstructures at Caroline Hill Road site. Mr. Leung Chee Chiang, 4 minutes. Thank you. Chairman. Is it that for 2017-2018, there will be all these projects that we will need to discuss? So are we going to discuss these items according to the priority as you've provided in the list? Mr. Lau, I think this the priority list, I think it's based on the date at which this project will start, as to whether or not they will be submitted in the say exact order to the PWSC. As I said at the beginning, it would depend on the preparation for the project's concern, including the consultation with the panel and so on. Well, I think you've already told us that earlier. But you are now putting forward a series of submissions. Some have been discussed by the relevant panels. I may not be a member of all the panels. Some of these may not have been discussed before. If you are to submit such a large number of items, today you're here just to inform us that there will be these submissions, but you're not consulting our views on these projects, right? Yes, that is correct. Today, the administration is simply here to brief us on these forecasts of submissions. So it's not really a formal application for funding. So in that case, I understand, because the content is too brief. So I don't think I would know how to discuss these items. Well, I heard that there have been four items for which there had been cost overruns. Would these items be submitted, you know, on a priority basis, or is it like the Undersecretary said that you will only submit them to this panel when all the information is ready? I believe that even for projects with cost overruns and the other funding applications, they will need to have all the information ready before they will be submitted. But for the Hong Kong-Macau Dry Bridge, I think the bridge is about to be commissioned in June, if I heard correctly. I don't know whether the government has a timetable. Mr. Chung. Thank you. Regarding the Hong Kong Zhuhai Macau Bridge and the date of commissioning, recently there have been some press report on this. But I would like to take this opportunity to say that the commissioning of this bridge would need to be decided by the State Council of the CPG. So far, there is no decision yet. So all the reports in the media and all the dates, you know, reported in the media are just speculations. Well, I said that I've heard that the commissioning day is June. We're now already in January. And we're going to have some holidays in between, after which we'll come back for meetings. If it is going to be commissioned in June and you have yet to submit this to the PWSC, does it mean that if you're not able to pay all the expenses, the bridge will still be commissioned nevertheless? Well, I think that it's very clear. That is, if the application for supplementary allocation is not approved, would that affect the commissioning of the bridge? We will try our best to apply for supplementary, you know, provision from LegCo. Director, I don't think he's the director's finished yet. Director, I've already said just now that the date of the commissioning of the bridge and the application for supplementary funding, there is no, direct relationship. If you say that the bridge can still be commissioned even if the outstanding balance have not yet been paid, how can the bridge be commissioned if you haven't paid all the expenses? So I think Mr. Leung's question is that for this project, the completion day is not affected by the date at which LegCo approved the application for supplementary allocation. Yes, I think what the chairman said reflects the current situation. As I said, there is no direct relationship between the two. But I've also said that the commissioning date will be decided by the State Council. And that is why, well, I don't know, you know, what are the factors that they were taking into consideration. So all I can say, as I said just now, is that there is no direct relationship here for the implementation of the project for the main bridge. Now, before the supplementary allocation has been approved, despite that, the project will still proceed. So is it that the supplementary funding for that, you don't need to come back to the PWSC? Or do we need to go through the relevant panel and then back to the PWSC before you go to the FC? I think time is up, so perhaps you can briefly respond to that question. Chairman, after we have all the information ready, only then will we go to consult the relevant panel, namely the transport panel. And then we will come to the PWSC after that. Mr. Yu Siwing, thank you. I remember that such estimates and forecasts, I think, we never had a similar discussion for which we would have a discussion of all the forecasts of submission for the whole year. I think it started since 2002. But looking at the costs for the various projects, most of them are below 200 million, and then from 200 to 500 million, and also more than 500 million. So the figures are not very meaningful. Although you've said in the latter part of the paper, for example, I'm concerned about the Fire Dragon Museum in Taihang and so on, the Sunny Bay project less than 500 million. So I think you should, you know, improve on your approach. For every project, every paper, you say the estimate is between 200 and 500 million. That's not very meaningful. Why didn't you tell us which are the projects which will cost, how many will cost less than 200 million? Otherwise, we may have the impression that the government is just paying lip service, as it's not really being very thorough. Reading the paper, I understand that you have conducted a study in respect of each of the projects. So you will take on board my suggestion. Regarding the Fire Dragon Museum in Taihang, of course we have to wait when the paper is submitted to us. I understand that the site is not very large. Will it really need to, does it really cost that much? For such revitalization project, other than the Fire Dragon Museum, I wonder whether there are other estimates outside of this project, and if so, what are these projects? Who would like to respond? Mr. Yam? Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Yu, for the question. For the Fire Dragon Museum in Taihang, in October, at the end of October 2017, we consulted the panel on this project. We told the panel that the tentative estimate is for 42.3 million. Other than this revitalization project, for phase four of the this project, we have the revitalization of the Lady Ho Tong Center, and also revitalization of the senior staff quarter of the old dairy farm in Poflum. We will submit all these three projects for funding approval to the PWSC. Of course, that is good news. I hope the government will revitalize more of these projects. Next, about the Sunny Bay Reclamation project. So what is the, do you have a concrete proposal yet, or do you have to wait until the reclamation is completed before you consult the public as to how the site will be reclaimed will be used? Mr. Lam, for the Sunny Bay Reclamation Project, a site investigation is part of the study. Sunny Bay is located in the northeast of Lantau. It will be developed as a leisure and tourism, area. So based on this theme, we will decide on the land use for the site. Of course, we will consult the public regarding how we should develop a site which is for modern reclamation. Do you have any sort of, direction or proposal to guide our discussion? So far, we haven't yet started the study, so we don't have any direction yet. But in March, we heard the views of the panel, and we will certainly take that into consideration as we proceed with the study. Mr. Wuchiwai. I may not be familiar with the other districts, but for Wong Tai Sin and Kowloon East, there are several projects which I'd like the administration to pay attention to. That is the redevelopment of the pedestrian link in Kun Tong. Even the DP and the district council have indicated that, have suggested you have not really considered the space between Hipwah Street and Matwah Street. We proposed that the landing at Matwah Street, you should provide for an escalator there to attract more pedestrian traffic. I hope you will consider that suggestion. Secondly, I'd like to invite you to look at, well, for the VTC campus in Kowloon East, the project is still being vetted by the Town Planning Board, but you've set the date for the third quarter of 2018 for submission. So what I'd like to ask is, what is this contract? In case the Town Planning Board has not yet resolved, has not made a decision, will the contract then be affected, and then would the government incur a loss as a result?
And the third question is about Moss Park on conversion of its swimming pool. Item 65. It is expected that the contractor would only start in the fourth quarter of 2018. The district council has waited for a long time, so is there the possibility of advancing the works? Because the district council and the community have talked about this heated pool for a long time, but works haven't started yet. So can you please brief the district council ASAP so that you can come and apply for funding ASAP? There are other projects more controversial, such as the service reservoir in Diamond Hill. It is even more controversial, and yet you have placed it at a very early position, but this one is relatively non-controversial. I hope the heated pool of Moss Park Swimming Pool Complex can be submitted earlier for early implementation. So Mr. Wu has got a few concerns. Which one from the administration? The pedestrian linkage system in town center of Kun Tong. Thank you. Yes, I will give due consideration to Mr. Wu's comments. And any other item? ASD Director, Mrs. Lam. Or rather, Mr. Yip from the ASD. Thank you. Regarding 8022EM, and that is VTC's new complex in Kowloon East. Mr. Wu said that the Town Planning Board is still considering its rezoning application. So the EB as well as the VTC are still planning, making plans for this project. It's expected that in late February, the item will be considered by the Town Planning Board. Depending on the decision of the TPB, we will submit a proposal to the council for consideration. There will not be any possibility of waste of project cost. What about the swimming pool, Mrs. Lam? Thank you. We will discuss it very proactively with LCSD. It's true that works are already in progress. We are not going to, not asking, I'm not talking about closing down the pool, but I'm asking whether it can be expedited, because you only start works in the fourth quarter. After funding is approved, we will call tenders and we will start the project at once. So the time is rather tight. Mr. Jeremy Tam, I have to declare interest. I have got property along the alignment of Central Shatin Link. Now, there is an item for the Kai Tak terminus. You only apply for funding in the fourth quarter of 2018. Can that be expedited? Because at Kai Tak Station, population intake has already started. And in 2019, or the beginning of 2019, the station is supposed to be commissioned. If you only make an application to the PWSCI in the fourth quarter of 2018, and by the time you have got approval of FC, then the item may not be completed until 2020 or 2021. So I'd like to know how much time will it take to complete the project. In fact, the target contract start date is shown here. So if they want to start the contract in the fourth quarter of 2018, of course, the item has to be submitted to the PWSCI and then FC earlier. So you want that to be even earlier? The plaza of Kai Tak Station. Mrs. Lam, we expect that funding can be obtained from the council in this quarter, and then the item can be upgraded to Cat A, and then we will have the tendering exercise. We have to fulfill the tendering procedures and timetables, so works can only start in end of this year. Regarding the completion date, the project has a big coverage. There is also interface with development projects around Kai Tak, so we expect that at around end of 2022, the project can be completed. Any follow-up, please? Nothing more. Thank you, Chairman. Next, Mr. Ray Chen. 4 minutes. Oh no, Mr. Eddie G has just arrived, so please take your seat first and give way to Mr. Ray Chen first. There are many controversial projects in the list. I didn't know whether the administration is observing our amendment to the FC procedures. Perhaps if the procedures are amended, perhaps you think that after a voting at PWSC, you can get money for the projects, and of course you will consider it more efficient. Now, I'm concerned about item 84 to 86, and that is cost overrun of the Sartin to Central Link and the Hong Kong German Car Bridge. Many people say that you want to approve the, to amend the procedures of FC. You want to treat LegCo as an ATM, and as soon as a project is approved in PWS, you don't have to go to FC anymore. So can you please tell us when you're going to brief the transport panel and the PWSC in relation to the Hong Kong German Car Bridge? What is your rough timetable? If you can tell us the month, that's the best. On the reclamation of Yano, when are you going to consult us, and are you going to brief the relevant panel first? I think Mr. Chung has already taken a question on Hong Kong German Macau Bridge, but Mr. Chung, once again, please. Thank you. As I explained earlier, we are talking about the main bridge within the mainland. The State Council has recently approved an increase in the project estimate. So it's reported in the media that the cost overrun may be around RMB 10 billion. And we have to foot about 2 billion RMB of the bill. However, we will not just come to seek funding for that amount, because we have not spent all the project estimate approved for this item. So we have to first verify what is left of the approved estimate before we can come up with the amount that of additional funding required. The works are carried out in the mainland, and they have their own system in project implementation. So we have to discuss with the relevant mainland departments and parties so that we can have detailed information before coming to LegCo for an explanation. I believe members would want to have comprehensive information. We have yet to get all the information needed, so we cannot fix a time for briefing the transfer panel and for submitting to the PWSC. All right, Mr. Zhong mentioned the mainland a number of times. I think this is rather sensitive, because in Hong Kong we have to say mainland and we should not say within the country. This is for political correctness. Now, I don't know whether you're as stringent as that in the government. And then yes, it should be the mainland instead of within the country. I think the mainland is an appropriate term. Oh, all right, allow me to ask a real question. So the balance of the approved estimate, you don't have to wait for information from the mainland to work that out. When can you tell us the balance of the approved estimate? Yes, it's easier to work out the balance of the APE, but there is some complicated parts here, because a part of the money is for contingency. And then there is also adjustment in forex or current exchange rate. So we'll have to work out the balance of the APE. And for information from the mainland departments, we are still waiting for all the information needed. So you have to wait for everything before you come to give us an account of the project. Yes, we don't want to just submit a sum without the justifications when it comes to the PWSC and FC. Mr. Lam, can you briefly respond to a reclamation at Sunny Bay? Do you have to go to YESI? In last March, we went to the relevant panel and we heard members' comments. We are following up on those comments. We intend to submit the item to PWSC within this quarter. So there is no need to go to the development panel again. They have already done so. Mr. IDG, 4 minutes.
Thank you, Chairman. So some members asked about the target contract start day. Is it in any way related to the time of submission of the item to the PWSC? So the quarter shown here may not be relevant to the submission day of the item to this subcommittee, right? My understanding is it should be earlier than the target contract start day. And if the tendering procedures are lengthy, then the item will have to be approved by the PWSC as well as FC earlier. And for some other items, the time processing time may be shorter, but for sure, funding has to be approved before that. Thank you. Well, at the start of every session, give us a list of the submissions to be for the PWSC this year. So Chairman, you're saying that so long as an item is approved before the contract start date, that is okay. There's no harm. So I think these projects should be submitted to the council earlier so that we can take it easy and you won't have to wait until the very last hour. And we may not have time to approve a certain item. For instance, retrofitting of air conditioning in Taiwan market, item 49 for the FHB. Well, we frequently mentioned the installation of air conditioning system at our public markets. I don't think this paper is too complicated to write. So through you, Chairman, can items that are relatively simple be submitted first, so long as they are not contradictory to the target contract start day, so that these items can be submitted first for reference? So Taiwan market is just an example.
Mrs. Lam, for this item, we expect that during the current electrical session, we would be able to submit this project for funding approval by electrical. After funding is approved, we will immediately invite tender for this project. Since we need to go through the tendering procedure, so we still have to wait until the end of 2018 before work will start. I don't think Mrs. Lam has answered my question. Regarding the order according to which the items will be submitted, Mr. Lau, basically all the projects involved in this work plan, the administration believes they are all important because they have to do with people's livelihood. We hope to be able to submit these items to the PWSC as soon as possible. As to which projects we will submit first, we will depend on the progress of the works concerned. For example, whether we've consulted the reference panel and whether we have obtained its support and so on. At this stage, I think at several meetings early on, we've been dealing with items brought forward from the previous electrical session. And for the new projects, we have already been incorporated them into the list. As preparation for the other projects are completed, we will immediately, include them onto the list. Mr. Chong Xing, thank you. Chairman, there are a few items on the list that I'd like to express our concern. First of all, for the Food and Health Bureau, item 41, redevelopment of Our Lady of Maranor Hospital. 2 days ago, the Wong Tai Sin District Council met, and you actually went there to consult its members. And all the council members agreed that the hospital should, enhance its services. But according to your proposal, you will only be adding one or two dozen hospital beds to deal with cancer patients. So being someone directly elected from Kowloon East constituency. I hope that when you consult the panel the next time, you have to respond to those questions raised by the councillors. They're concerned about the 24-hour emergency service and so on. And secondly, another colleague asked a question regarding the heated pool in Moores Park. This is a very important item for Wong Tai Sin, and we hope that you will try your best. Please don't delay this any further. We expect that you would expedite this project. Another question I'd like to ask is Tai Wai Market, the installation of air conditioning for Tai Wai Market. I'd like to ask why you've left out the air conditioning of the Sherry Wall Street Market in your list. Is it that you haven't yet gone to the panel or what? I'd just like the administration to give us an answer. Again, it would be Mrs. Lam. I'm sorry, I don't have the information offhand. I will relay your questions to the FEHD. And we'll give you a written response after the meeting. Okay, that's in respect of the Sherry Wall Market. What about Our Lady of Maranor Hospital and the Sherry Wall Street Market? Regarding Our Lady of Maranor Hospital, the member referred to the suggestion by the District Council that the hospital should increase its service provision. This is an item under the Food and Health Bureau. We will certainly relay the member's comment to the Bureau concerned so that when they submit the paper to the panel, they will address the questions asked by the member. I'm sure our colleagues, the ministers have heard your concern, and this issue will be taken up by the relevant panel. Now, do we have any other questions? If not, then we may now adjourn this special meeting because we don't have any further questions. The date of the next meeting will be the 17th of January, a Wednesday, at 8:35. So for the Wednesday meeting, we will continue to scrutinize the PWSC funding application. Thank you very much.